And here in the play-in, 21 points on 10 of 18 from the field.
He's available every game, every year. He plays all the time. As durable as any player in this league.
Kuzma back out to Schroeder. Shot clock at three. Puts up the three. Shot won't go. Wanted the foul. Davis, the offensive rebound. Back up and banks it home.
Well, there's an awful lot of contact. Not just on the shot, but also Davis's rebound and finish.
Anthony Davis discarded people.
Curry reverse with the English off the glass. A little more magic from Steph Curry. He's got 33.
And LeBron James is coming back in.
Schroeder drives inside. Caruso missed the layup. Curry the rebound. Curry to Wiggins. Jordan Poole. Nope, they wave it off. An offensive foul.
You want to say on the screen set by Draymond Green.
They led by 13 at halftime. Lakers have taken the lead here in the fourth. They've led by as many as seven. Right now, all tied with 4.5 to play.
And this is a tough play to guard. The curl by Davis.
Davis knocked away. Another steal from Draymond Green. And Mulder in the front court. Three steals, three blocks for Green. Curry on the drive, gets inside. Foul line jumper, no good. 11 rebounds for Davis to go with 21 points. Mulder up and into Schroeder. Drives, layup, shot is good. Oh, what a tough shot from Schroeder. And Draymond Green wanted a push off. Green's got to be careful with the referees. He already has a technical tonight. Gets the pass from Curry. Pull for three. Puts it in. Warriors back up by one.
And that's where Green is great. You blitz Curry. And you get it to Green and he plays four on three. He's a great, great decision maker.
And it may boil down to just that. Other guys not named Curry making shots, being ready and aggressive because the Lakers are forcing Curry to get rid of the basketball.
Dennis Schroeder tries, drives on Wiggins, flips it up, shot no good. Rebound Draymond Green. And here come the Warriors up one with 3:15 remaining. Curry fakes, Curry drives, floats it up, banks it home. Timeout Lakers.
I think it's the right move.
Absolutely. They got to make an adjustment because the Warriors clearing a side for Curry. They have to recognize that defensively, the Lakers do, and be in position to help.
James looking to post up Bazemore. Squares and faces. Seven on the shot clock. Wiggins looking to help. James, four on the 24. James jumper, short. Rebound Matthews. Back out to James. Pass to Caruso. Corner three. Side of the backboard, and Bazemore gets the rebound.
Now, I talked about it earlier, Wiggins forcing LeBron into that shot. That's a shot you're willing to give up if you're the Warriors defensively against a bigger, stronger LeBron.
And Caruso's defense forces the turnovers. Curry dribbles it out of bounds. And Caruso inside to Davis, the runner. No good, but a foul.
That's absolutely inexcusable. On a turnover, they didn't get matched up. So Green had to rotate to the wide open Caruso, and now Davis gets fouled.
So Poole picks up his third, and Anthony Davis will shoot free throws. Two for two tonight. It's only 74% during the season.
All right, Christine, three words. Let's go.
Play-in basketball neighbor.
All right, let me see. This week, I'm going to stay in. Watch the NBA playing. What is you saying?
Okay.
If it's mine, I want it. I'll never pass it off like basketball.
Okay.
And if it's about that paper, no, I'm on a tear. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Big second half for Davis. Only had 5 points at halftime. 18 in the second half. 1 point game, under 2.5 remaining. Curry on the drive, the floater in the paint, short. Wiggins tips it, but right to Davis. James running the floor. Pass to Caruso, back to James, and he's fouled. Draymond Green would not let him get a layup. So again, as Steve Javi said, it was an awkward fall, and that made it look worse than it was, and apparently got poked in the eye too.
My only problem with it wasn't a contest to the basketball. It was a contest to the face.
It's because he can't jump as well.
Ties the game with 2:07 remaining.
I've been there before, squinting my eyes just in case I miss a free throw, so I have an excuse. I've been there.
Had a rough first half, but has made huge plays here in the second half. A triple-double. Misses the second. And a loose ball foul is going to go against LeBron James. Jordan Poole did a good job pursuing that rebound.
And really, you look right now, both teams are shooting the rest of the way. So if you're going to be physical defensively, you have to be physical and disciplined also, where you don't give up free throws.
Each team with one timeout left, and as Mark said, both teams in the penalty. Bazemore to Poole. Wiggins, Green, and Curry. And an out call on Draymond Green on the moving screen. Wes Matthews draws that turnover. Steve Kerr can't believe that call. Nor can Green, who picks up his fifth.
And that's not an illegal screen to me. That's Wes Matthews selling the foul.
He's had an important impact on this second half.
Caldwell Pope back up to James. Wiggins has done an excellent job defensively on him tonight. Shot clock at 6. James looking to get a running start now. Pass to Caruso. Caruso on the drive. Inside Davis for the slam. Lakers back up 2 with a minute and a half to play.
And Caruso has been outstanding.
Outstanding. Great find.
Curry the drive, looking to draw contact, and he does, but they say before the shot, doesn't matter, they're in the penalty. Half has come alive, 25 points, including 13 here in the fourth quarter, as Curry hits the free throw.
And played 41 minutes so far.
12 rebounds as well, and has made some excellent defensive plays in the second half. This game has been so much about defense from both teams. Curry ties the game. 37 points for Steph Curry. They get it to Caldwell Pope. Almost lost it. Shot clock at 7. James, two defenders on him, to Caldwell Pope inside. He's tied up by Green. Throws it back up top. James puts up the 3. Oh, it's good! LeBron James from downtown as the shot clock expires. A desperation heave, and the Lakers are up 3. Green back to Curry. Curry sets, leans in. Knocked away, get it back from Curry. Shot clock at 7. Bazemore on the drive, kicks it out. Poole for 3. James the rebound with 32 seconds remaining. There's about a 10-second difference, shot clock and game clock. They don't have to foul.
If I'm LeBron James, I'm putting my head down and attacking.
Lost the ball, gets it back. Matthews for 3. Fight for the rebound. Tipped twice. Picked up by Poole. 10 seconds remaining.
I'm in a foul. I'm not letting him shoot a 3.
They have a timeout left, but won't call it here. Kerr's trying to call it, and finally he gets it. Steve Kerr came to half court. The officials couldn't see him or clearly couldn't hear him. And he gets the timeout with 2:01 remaining. Poole coming free. Curry trying to get free. Lost the ball. That's it. The Lakers are in the playoffs. The Warriors need to play on Friday. What a thriller here at the Staples Center. They are swarming Steph Curry. Soon as he crosses half court, Draymond Green down the lane. Layup shot is good. It's back to 5. 2 minutes remaining.
That's a great finish by Draymond Green.
2 hoops in a row. They need him to score and think score.
Morant again on the drive on Toscano Anderson. Blocked from behind by Curry. Still got the shot off, and Curry comes the other way. Curry, Toscano Anderson, back to Poole for three. And a foul called on the three-point attempt. Desmond Bane can't believe it. Bane picks up the foul, and Poole will shoot three free throws.
And I'm shocked, absolutely, because first of all, he kicks his foot out. Second of all, it's a minute 43 to go in the game. If you don't use it now, when are you going to use it?
And even if you just take your time out, you still have one left. I mean, that is, it doesn't get more obvious to me than that.
Jordan Poole, most important free throws of his brief NBA career, knocks down all three. Two-point game, minute and a half remaining. Ja Morant to the rim, layup, it's no good. Rebound taken by Wiggins.
And I'm still going all out on Steph Curry. Draymond Green scores, I can live with it.
Curry on the drive. Curry inside, missed it, but fouled. And Steph Curry will shoot two free throws and a chance to tie the game. 35 points for Steph Curry. Big free throws right now being made by the Golden State Warriors. The best free throw shooter in NBA history ties the game. 9 straight points now for Golden State. They were down 10 with 3.5 to play. Morant back up top. Anderson 7 on the 24. Anderson drives inside, he's fouled, shot won't go, and Steph Curry just picked up his fifth personal. Talk about guys hitting pressure free throws, season on the line.
I mean, think about it, Mike, 5 straight free throws for Golden State, and now Anderson to go ahead. You got to make guys make shots.
The winner plays Utah Sunday in the first round of the playoffs. The loser, their season is over. Clutch free throws from Kyle Anderson. Grizzlies back up 2. Under a minute remaining. Both teams in the penalty. Each team still has timeouts. Curry chased by 2 defenders. Finds Draymond Green. Green pass to Poole. Poole fakes a 3, trying to draw a foul. Gets it back. Poole inside. Clutch inside to Wiggins. He ties the game. 33 seconds remaining.
No timeout. Playing on.
They're going to put Steph Curry in the action, and Draymond Green switches. They're trying to make Curry be the guy to switch.
Ja Morant off the dribble, pulls back, kicks it out to Bane. 5 on the 24. Kyle Anderson, 2 to shoot. Anderson drives, back out. 3-pointer, 24-second violation. 7.8 remaining. Now they put a little time back on the clock. The Warriors will have a chance to win it on the final possession.
And Steve Kerr, no timeout either.
9.2 remaining. Again, no fouls to give for Memphis.
If I'm the Warriors, I can guarantee a look the way that they're defending Steph Curry. So I like the idea of no timeout.
5 seconds remaining. Curry makes his moves, finds Green. Green drives down a lane, the floater's up, no good. Overtime.
And great substitution by Taylor Jenkins to start overtime and getting Allen in the game.
Wiggins backs in, up top to Green, left wide open, connects, clutch 3 from Draymond Green, his first 3-point attempt of the night. Big shot after big shot, and it's a 1-point game here in overtime. Morant searching, Anderson, Tillman up top to Morant, 5 on the 24. Three-pointer Morant. Rebound Wiggins. Curry's played 45 minutes. Double-teamed again. Wiggins, step-back two-pointer. Won't go. Toscano Anderson trying to keep it alive. Knocked off Kyle Anderson. There's 2:07 left in overtime. Anderson trying to say, no, it wasn't me.
That looked like it was off Anderson.
And a timeout called. Green shooting just 27% from three on the season. Well, that was a clutch shot. Brooks hounding Curry. Green pass inside. Toscano Anderson back to Green. Green looking, finds Curry. Curry for three. Bounces twice, won't go. Toscano Anderson the rebound. Pull for three. Bang! Golden State back up by two. Allen to Anderson. Poole picks up John Morant. Morant gets in the paint, stops, kicks it back out in the corner. Tillman for three, puts it in as the shot clock expires. Xavier Tillman, what a performance off the bench. Toscano Anderson to Wiggins. Wiggins tries a three. Way off, and Morant the rebound. Coming up on a minute remaining.
Don't run the clock out. You got bailed out the last time. Give yourself enough time to create a second drive.
Morant picked up by Curry. Again, Curry with five fouls. Shot clock at three. Morant gets inside. A little push shot is good. 33 for John Morant and a three-point Grizzly lead.
Great patience and uses the upper body strength to get to his spot and elevate.
Curry dancing, draws the foul before the shot attempt. And it's the first foul in the last 2 minutes. So not in the penalty. Golden State will inbound.
Take a look at how he finishes this play. Uses the upper body strength to shield off Steph Curry and create more space.
That is a big-time shot.
Such poise for the 21-year-old. Curry again facing the double team. Finds Draymond Green. Wiggins double team. Back out to Green. They go to Jordan Poole. Poole dribbling. Lost it out of bounds with 27.9 remaining. And Golden State down by three.
And they're not going to foul and play the free throw game. So you need to run it all the way down if you're Memphis.
There's only 4 seconds difference, shot clock and game clock. Tillman back to Morant. Throw it ahead to Allen.
Now if you're John Morant, I'd milk the clock. And I don't want anybody else involved. I want to take advantage. I'm the franchise guy. Make a play.
And Morant shoot at the last second.
Four to shoot. Morant makes his move. Spins in the paint. Turns. Puts it up. Puts it in. John Morant knocks it down. It's a five-point game with 4.5 remaining. Poole, corner three. It's good. Knocks down the three with 2.2 remaining. It's back to a two-point game. And a timeout. Taylor Jenkins to advance the ball. Looks for a teammate. Finds out Brooks. And Brooks quickly fouled with 1.7 remaining. Looking to help out on ball denial. Anderson looking. Finds Bane. Bane inside. He throws it down. And that will do it. Count the basket and the foul. The lead is up to four with 1.2 remaining. The rookie Desmond Bane. Another of these young Grizzlies.
And again, great poise by Kyle Anderson to not throw it in the backcourt, find Bane, and seal the deal.
It's like having a veteran quarterback. He allowed the play to develop and made the right read.
Morant was the leading scorer, but players like Kyle Anderson, Desmond Bane, Xavier Tillman making so many big plays, and that will do it. The Memphis Grizzlies are in the playoffs. They eliminate the Golden State Warriors. And the Grizzlies will now play the Jazz in the first round starting on Sunday.
A rebound by Mann. Out to Paul. Dives into the paint. Jackson three. Rebound by Malik Beasley. Russell for the lead.
Absolutely right, because you know what you're going to get from Carl Anthony Towns. I mean, you didn't think you were going to get this bad of a game, but Russell's the one guy who's a closer.
It's a 14-2 Minnesota run. Morris and the pesky Beverly is there. Shot clock is down to 7. Jackson, Beverly, shot clock at 3. He pokes it away. On the floor, they're playing Twister, and it gets tied up. Jump ball. Oh, the defense!
And if they jump this at half court, if I'm Minnesota, I don't even try to go for it. Oh, so now this is an advantage, or it helps the Clippers, because look at the clock. 0.8 left on the clock. So it's not a possession. But if the Clippers get it and get a quick shot, they can get up. It's got to be in the air, though.
Timberwolves, by the way, have outscored the Clippers 11-2 since Towns fouled out of the game at the 7:34 mark. Jackson for the Clippers. McDaniels for the Wolves. Volley balled up and a rebound by Minnesota. They come the other way, up by 2 and approaching 4 to play. The winner secures a playoff slot and a date with Memphis. Edwards, hold on!
Oh, my goodness.
We're taking care of some moisture on the other side, and here we go. Jackson. And Daniels will be on him. Minnesota's got 3 timeouts. Clippers have 1 left. And it's Paul George. And Vanderbilt is on him. Now they switch. It's a 3 by Morris. And a rebound by Vanderbilt. He's got 10.
Timeout, Anthony Edwards and Russell.
Carl Anthony Towns fouled out 4 minutes ago. Russell and Edwards have been terrific. Beverly's got the ball right now. It's Batum watching Russell. Cutting off, Edwards slides into the paint and covered by 3, and the ball charred free in 7 to fire.
Think about this. They're running a go-to play for Anthony Edwards, second-year player, the overall number one pick in 2020, and you've got Paul George, one of the elite wing defenders, guarded him. I mean, it doesn't get any better than this.
Now, Paul George, a 6-time all-defensive team selection. Reed, 3. Chased, out of bounds, Jackson and Beverly.
I think they're going to call a foul on Reggie Jackson. I think they're going to call a foul on Reggie Jackson.
Look at that. Wow.
See, this is why you cannot draft, you cannot trade for heart and hustle. And that's what Patrick Beverly gives you. This is what you missed out on.
Beasley, 3. No, he leads the team in 3-point shooting for the season by a large margin. Here comes Paul George. And he'll sneak and slither and feed to Batum. 3. Good. Big shot by Nicholas Batum.
Well, big,
1-point game.
Big play by Paul George.
Yep.
His dribble penetration. So many white jerseys around him.
Edwards thinking 3 and popping a 3.
Step back 3, not just a 3. Step back 3.
27 for Anthony Edwards. Jackson and Edwards. Setting up. It's Batum, shot clock at 5, another 3. That time he misses, and the rebound by Beverly. 2.5 to go.
Pick and pop situation with Reed. Watch Reed's 3.
Edwards picked up by now Batum before Zubac as he tries to pierce the paint. It's a 3, and it's off by Beverly. It's retrieved by George, who lost it to Russell.
Gotta run some time now.
Oh, my goodness.
Can't be in a hurry now.
But the shot clock at 7, the screen, and the 2. the biggest lead for Minnesota. D'Angelo Russell knocks it in. Give him 29. That three won't go. Rebound by Zubats. Intercepted on the play. Russell. Numbers four on one. Edwards three. No. And it's out of bounds. Has been eye-opening over the last seven-plus minutes.
Offensive foul on Edwards.
Edwards, you better believe it. Plenty of time and a six-point deficit, and Jackson will take it the other way. Edwards is on him. George will launch a three. Big shot by Paul George. Three-point game, 31 for George.
And the Clippers are used to these type of comebacks. They've had so many of them this season.
Russell's got 29, chiseling his way for a 15-footer. Rebound by Paul. Outside it goes for George, and there is a foul on Russell.
Bring back Batum for Zubats.
Jackson picked up by McDaniels. Hesitates and accelerates and takes it inside. Ball is loose, picked up by McDaniels.
What a look. He had a wide open layup. Yeah, go one-on-one versus Morris. Use your speed.
And he takes it right to the rack. Zubats was there, and a foul called on the Clippers. Right. 27 points. And he notches one right there. Anthony Edwards, the number one overall pick. He was the SEC Freshman of the Year at Georgia under Tom Crean. Fourth-rated high school player. And he's got the fourth most points for a player 21 or under. And back of LeBron, Kobe, and Melo. And he just drains that second free throw to give him 29. Towns fouled out, 7.5 to play in the fourth. Trying to survive without him. George has the ball. It's a spinning three, and it was over the defense that time of Vanderbilt and the Wolves the other way. And a foul as Beverly was off to the races and out of the blocks with 32 seconds to go. Beverly's got 10 rebounds tonight.
He's one of the better rebounding guards in our league.
Best offensive rebounding guard. He's number one. He is the number one rebounding guard, 6'4 or under inside.
Oh, he's saying he's loving it. Because this is payback for his old team. This is, you could have had me. You could have brought me to the dance,
he
right?
He says, if you can't pay me, you got to trade me. And they did, and eventually ended up with Minnesota.
Oh, boy,
he's a piece of work.
I love him.
He is the most impactful player on a team that has doubled their wins from last year.
They lost the ball!
Beverly did it!
And he's having words for Stephen Ballmer walking by him. Look at this. John, get your sleep.
We're going to see two young, athletic teams. Now listen, it's still 6 points. There's 21 seconds to go. Edwards at the line, gets the back end of two to give him 30 for the game. 7-point game. Here comes George. Gliding by midcourt, losing some time right there. McDaniels will defend. Uncorks
a
three.
What a shot there.
4-point game. 12 seconds to go. And a timeout taken by Minnesota. They have one left. The Clippers out of timeouts. Beverly will do it. Wolves have a timeout, and they get it off right there to Edwards. Drives that baseline, kicks it out. They hold the ball. The clock is ticking. A foul committed by Batum.
11 points and fouling out. It was tonight.
Beasley at the stripe. Beverly with some instructions for his team. And a 5-point lead with 6.4 to go. Listen, and picked up by Beverly, and that's all she wrote. The Timberwolves are going to the playoffs. Here comes Jackson, who's been marvelous tonight. Morris has as well. Shakes the defense of Nance. Great defense from behind. Pelicans get the block.
And the block from behind there by Nance. He got beat initially. Here's the double team on Ingram.
They're going at him with Covington and Batum. Ingram tries to make a move off the baseline. Trevin Jones reverse. No. Valanciunas stuffs it home.
Nance Jr. Oh, with the putback.
Excuse me. Right. It was Nance inside. Got it to go.
That's his seventh offensive rebound. 16 overall for the game.
Nance with a big-time jam inside on the feed. Pelicans have led by 16. Clippers have led by 13. Seven ties. Nance had the block at the other end on the drive by Morris.
There's the block from the back and the missed layup by Jones, but who's there?
Nance puts it through hard. Foul was just called on Jones.
16 rebounds, 7 offensive, and 14 points off the bench here for Nance Jr.
And here comes Jackson and McCollum in his way. The 2 points go at it and over two, including Nance, and a rebound inside collected by Murphy.
And what was Willie Green telling his guys during one of those timeouts that we played? You've got to fight, win or go home.
It's Ingram on top. 22-7 run by New Orleans. Doubled again, cutting his Nance. It goes out to McCollum, who got by man and hits the shot. 4-point lead by the Pelicans on a 24-7 run. Morris on top. He'll put up a three. No! Rebound collected by Murphy.
And they've got numbers because man is down at the other end.
It's McCollum, late closed by Morris. And Batum will collect it. And Batum the other way and approaching 2.5 to go with Jackson on top and perusing. 26 points for Jackson. Drives on McCollum. It's deflected. Almost taken by Murphy. Claimed by Covington. Puts it up and there. Jones the rebound.
Now there's a lid down here for the Clippers, right?
Driving is Ingram right into a thicket of defenders. And there was a whistle on the side before he got to the lane.
Doing an unbelievable job on the glass here.
Batum picked up his fourth. McCollum has it and Powell's on him.
Where's the double going to come from?
Covington's on Ingram. It's outside. Murphy, three. Good! It bounces in! What a lucky bounce! Right through, 7-point Pelican lead, 2 to go on a 27-7 run. This game has been full of big runs like that. Batum, back to Morris, corner, it's Powell, got it!
What an answer, and a much needed one by Norman Powell and the Clippers here.
It's a 4-point game, McCollum on the side. Powell is there.
Talked about these young Pelicans growing up on the fly. Trey Murphy off the bench now with 14.
Ball was out of bounds. Shot clock at 13. Pels to inbound. Here is Ingram and Covington in the way. And Batum is going to come out and join them. Murphy left free. Jackson comes over. Into the paint. Off. It's picked up by Morris. Jackson saves it.
What a save by Reggie Jackson.
Some kind of save indeed. Morris will drive and feed, and Covington sucking off the opposite side, gets it to go. A 2-point game.
Who wants to take the shot here for the Pelicans? Oh, there's a push there by Batum.
Among rookies, the fourth best free throw percentage. And at the line for the first time tonight.
Act like you've been there before, right?
There's David Griffin, who is the man in charge of basketball for the Pelicans. Made the trade at midseason, made the trade before the season for Valanciunas. And signed these kids, including Jones, who he drafted in the second round out of Alabama. It's Reggie Jackson. Team down by 4 minutes to go. Now down to 53 and Morris. A long shot which will not drop, and a rebound by McCollum.
As much time as possible and make a play.
Nance. It's Murphy. And picked up by Covington. And here comes Jackson. Got to fire into Nance. Taking it in. Up and off. And a foul on Nance.
That's four on Nance Jr. And this is the best case scenario, other than knocking down a three, if you're Ty Lue and the Clippers, because you score with no time coming off the clock here and you get a chance to set your defense. See right there, New Orleans has two timeouts left. The Clippers one.
Jackson at the stripe, 6 of 7. 85% throughout the season.
Valanciunas getting ready to come back in for rebounding purposes.
Yep.
Which lets me know that Coach Willie Green will probably call a timeout if Jackson is successful here, so he can advance the basketball as well as take out Valanciunas.
The rookie Murphy will leave. Valanciunas is in. Ingram, McCollum, Valanciunas, Herb Jones out there for the Pelicans, and Nance. Jackson misses the second. Jones is there, and a timeout taken by New Orleans. They've got a 3-point lead with 26 seconds to go. The winner goes to the playoffs. 16 from Powell off the bench, and Covington with 14.
If you're Coach Lou and the Clippers, you try and go for a steal, maybe two.
One timeout apiece. Ingram gets it. Jackson falls.
You got him.
Batum had it. They're going to throw it away. Jones was there, and a body and Jackson flying off the floor. 20.9, and they get it into Nance. And a quick foul on Covington as Nance caught and fed, and Covington's got 5.
Nice job and composure by the rookie, Herb Jones. Not panicking, taking the ball out. This is a rookie in this situation.
Clippers lost that challenge, lost a timeout. One remaining for them. Nance at the free throw line for the first time tonight.
Still life here. Clippers do have a timeout left where they can advance the basketball if this is a miss by Nance Jr.
In 7 games played for the Pelicans coming into tonight, he was 8 of 8 from the line. But he misses number 1. And he misses number 2. And a timeout by the Clippers, and 19 seconds to go in a 3-point game. 19 seconds to go. Clippers will have it down by 3 on TNT. And on him will be Trey Murphy.
And Morris and Jackson, you would think, are going to have the basketball in their hands. Don't forget about Norman Powell.
Powell has it, bumping into Nance, and there's a foul on Nance.
And that's not bad, because now you've got to go to the free throw line and make both of them. But again, if you're Powell, you could make the first, be down by 2, and purposely miss the second and see if you can come up with the offensive glass. But I don't see Zubats on the floor or Hartenstein to kind of help with the rebounding. So you make them both and play the free throw game. But he misses the first. Misses the first. The Clippers tonight from the free throw line, 21 of 33, 64%.
As their owner, Steve Ballmer, watches on. 16.9. Powell from the line tonight, 3 of 6. Two-point game. Timeout, New Orleans.
52%.
No. He's got Ingram. Doubled over there. Underneath! It's Valanciunas with the stuff! 12.6, no timeouts. Down by four. Jackson the other way. Hurls a three. Morris has got the ball. He'll put up an off-balance three. And the Pelicans are going to win it! The Pelicans are going to the playoffs! Since he'll come here in the fourth. Hachimura. LeBron. Thinking three. He'll try to tie right here.
This is very reminiscent of that three he made against Golden State in the play-in game a few years ago.
James with 30 points. Have lost a lot of games, win by 10 or more. Second most in the NBA, tied now at 95. Here comes Towns. He's got 24 for the lead right here. Now, another miss. Lakers have only led by 2 points early in the game. Have trailed by as many as 15.
Got to be all LeBron here to make a play. He's got the switch he wants and the step back.
James, another three! Over the backboard on the ricochet and is again. So this is the second tie right here. With 9 lead changes, they were all early. And the Timberwolves have missed 6 in a row and they come the other way.
But to me, Anthony Edwards has struggled all night. Go get yours, young man.
Here comes Edwards. Reeves is on town. Shot clock at 8. Towns making a move. Outside, it's a 3. And Conley can't hit. It's picked up by Schroeder. Under a minute to go. Reeves the other way. Towns will meet him defensively. James down low. Draws the double. He threw it away. He threw it away. And here comes Minnesota. Edwards. Towns. Edwards, 3 for the lead. Off again. Edwards is 1 of 11.
2-for-1 opportunity if the Lakers want it.
Timeout, Los Angeles.
The screen and roll. And here's a steal by Torian.
Trans, oh, look at the dive right there by James, but a foul called on the play. At the end of 3, 86-79, they led at halftime by 11. It's Towns. Picked up by Davis. The switch knocked away. Anderson on it. Over and back. It's LA's ball. And Davis out there awaiting the inbound from James. Minnesota's got a timeout.
Here's the defense. Anthony Edwards wanted to be a better two-way player. This is how you get it done.
LeBron against Edwards. The switch on defense. Now on Prince. LeBron takes it in, gets it out, Schroeder, good!
Make sure you are not fouling in the act of shooting if you're going to take a foul.
Anderson looks for the open man. It's a three.
And it's a foul on Anthony Davis.
And Anthony
contesting.
Davis.
A foul on Anthony Davis.
This is Minnesota's first free throw attempt this half.
Oh, my goodness. That was a nervous Nelly first free throw there by Conley. And he has 2 more to go. You love playing basketball. This is what you want.
No timeouts.
Oh, man, that's pressure. That is absolute pressure.
And we've got overtime.
Oh, my goodness.
Ball go through. It's a 3 by Edwards. 0 of 8. And LeBron chugging the other way. to Davis. Good looking catch.
Did you see how high LeBron threw the ball? There was only one man in this building that was going to be able to get it, and that was AD. Here, and the way they've shot the three ball through three quarters, see if they can recapture that.
James with the 30 points, the 89 30-point-plus game since reaching age 35. He continues to amaze. Down by five, Bulls with it. Edwards had it poked away. Schroeder, shot clock 13 for Minnesota.
Man, Schroeder's everywhere. Offensively, defensively, now he's in the chest of Edwards.
Hachimura will try to usher Anderson.
Shot clock running down.
Again, the shot clock at four. Edwards behind the back, around Davis into the hole. Up and off and tap back up and in by Towns. Will not count. Davis and James with double-doubles tonight. And it's Schroeder. Conley is on him. Schroeder will drive down the lane, tap in Davis off, picked up by Conley, off to the races.
Three would go a long way.
With a whistle.
Offensive foul on Edwards.
Edwards picks it up. Under a minute to go, Lakers by five. 23rd Minnesota turnover.
LeBron doing the right thing, taking time off the clock here.
Hachimura a screen on Prince. LeBron will make a move with a bump. That's a foul. That's an offensive foul on the Lakers on Rui Hachimura.
Pretty much the same call we just saw on Anderson, right? Not being set on the screen. Still moving. A lot of this, too, goes to LeBron. He's got to allow Rui to get set before he starts his move. We can get a quick three here on the 2-for-1.
Conley sizing him up. Davis on the perimeter. Anderson with the move. Shot clock at 10. Edwards floating in, gets the two. 3-point game, 19 seconds to go.
Timeout, Lakers.
Anthony Davis, 23-15, 4 assists.
Minnesota only 16 points since the end of the third quarter. Here's a steal.
It's Conley with the steal. In the corner, Prince for the tie. No! Rebound Reeves, leaping high, and a foul! Quickly the inbound Schroeder. Looks like he's running to Dusseldorf there.
And showing off the, those Jets right there. And that's with a sore right Achilles and a little bit of a turned ankle on the left side.
So Schroeder, who is 6 of 6, will be at the free throw line. He was trying to run out the clock. He was getting chased there by Alexander Walker, who had just checked in, and Schroeder will be at the stripe. The free throw difference. Lakers are 19 to 20. Minnesota is 14 to 15.
Minnesota still has a timeout left here.
Hachimura, Davis, Schroeder, Reeves, and James, the Laker five. Conley, Edwards, Anderson, Towns, and Torian Prince for Minnesota. 8.4, another free throw, Schroeder. It's a 5-point game and a timeout by the Timberwolves with 8.4 to go in overtime.
Kevin.
So Anderson, Lynn Brown, and Hachimura is jumping up and down in front of him. Over the head of Towns. Another turnover. That's 24 for the Timberwolves. LeBron said before the game, we've got to stay on the edge of our seat. We've got to play with an edge for this play-in game. Same one we've played with over the last quarter of the season with the foul on Anthony Davis. It goes on the Timberwolves. Anderson, he's got 5. AD to the line, 6.9 to go. And the Los Angeles Lakers, who have won 9 of their last 11, winning big against Utah by 11 here Sunday, are looking at that number seven spot.
And as much as this will sting for Minnesota, and it will,
yep,
being in control through three quarters, you've got to kind of let this go, refocus, because you're going to be hosting the game on Friday. The winner of that,
they'll be at the target center, yes, in Minnesota, and they'll play there with the loose ball, and Anderson's got it. And Edwards, who tonight struggled 3 of 16 and 3 of 17. The Los Angeles Lakers will play the 2-seed Memphis Grizzlies.
Loser of this game, season is done. Williams to Giddey. Giddey wants a screen. Giddey gets a screen, spins inside, feet inside on a travel.
Get out of his way and let him make a play, whether it's for himself or for his teammates.
That's only their seventh turnover of the game. Pelicans only 9.
Very clean played game.
Herbert Jones using a screen, drives inside, a little out of control. Giddey comes the other way. Back to Dort. Dort fires up a three. Way off. Rebound goes to Hayes. Ingram spins. Ingram shoots. Can't get it. The follow. Back up and throws it down. Timeout OKC. New Orleans with a 2-point lead with 3:12 remaining. Full court pressure. Now they back off.
There's Jalen Williams,
the former Santa Clara star, handling it, gets it to Giddey. McCollum on him. Good ball denial from Jones. Giddey turns, drives, gets inside, stripped, knocked out of bounds. And it's still OKC ball, 6 to shoot. Some good hands on that drive. Both these teams have played some tough, tough defense tonight. On the inbound pass, nearly stolen. Ingram nearly steals it again. Now they have 3.6 to shoot.
And the way they're reacting to Gilgeous-Alexander, Jalen Williams has to look to step to the ball as Jackson Hayes almost double teams him on this cut.
Giddey looking, gets it back, fires away from the corner. And a loose ball foul is going to be called on Murphy. Luke Dort was in there in great position. That's 3 on Murphy.
Gilgeous-Alexander's got to get the ball.
Has it now. There's the double team. They want it out of his hands. Find Giddey. Giddey fast pass inside. And Williams with the stuff. Tied once again.
But he gets the ball and then makes the right read. You've done your job. Once you take two guys, he puts Giddey in position to make the play to Williams.
10 assists for Josh Giddey with 29 points and 9 rebounds. Ingram gets inside. Jumper's good. Answers right back.
Talked about him making the adjustment. Uses force against force. Get to his space and then elevates.
Gilgeous-Alexander to Williams. Another Williams a three. Won't go. Rebound Murphy. 2 minutes remaining. Pelicans with the ball and a 2-point lead. Eight to shoot. Ingram drives, pulls back, drives again. Lost the handle. Picked up by Gilgeous-Alexander. Into the paint, around, bank shot is good, and we're tied again.
So good at forcing turnovers and converting them in transition.
That's the first points of the fourth for Gilgeous-Alexander after that magnificent third quarter. Hayes trying to hand it off. Dort fighting. Ingram driving. Pulls up jumper. Got it! Brandon Ingram, another big bucket. Jones again, ball denial, so Giddey has it. Giddey crossover, gets inside, turns. He's tied up. Back out Williams. Jalen Williams, the drive. Sweeping hook won't go, but he's fouled.
70% from the line during the regular season and misses the first.
And if I'm down at the other end, I have to be more aggressive against Brandon Ingram and make him find Jackson Hayes or Herb Jones.
Knocks down the second one-point game.
And to me, if you're New Orleans, the luxury of not just having Brandon Ingram, but also a veteran in C.J. McCollum, who's comfortable making plays down the stretch of a ball game.
Both teams with still two timeouts left. Hayes looking. He missed a cutting Murphy. Jones up top to McCollum. McCollum on the drive. The floater's up. Shot no good. Williams the rebound. 35 seconds remaining.
They'd want to get a two for one if they could.
Gilgeous Alexander drives. Gets inside. The floater is good. Oh, what a shot from Gilgeous Alexander. And the Thunder back up by one. Timeout New Orleans.
Offensive rebounder.
Ingram trying to get free. Dort right with him. Ingram makes a quick decision. Drives Dort. Banging. Goes back out. McCollum looking for Ingram. Ingram posting up. Turns. Fires. Shot no good. Williams the rebound. Now to Giddey. They have to foul. And Giddey is fouled by Herbert Jones with 12 seconds remaining. What a game for Giddey. 30 points, 10 assists, 9 rebounds at 20 years old.
And Willie Green already signaled he wants a timeout and make a miss.
How about that clutch free throw shooting? And Willie Green will call timeout. And that will be their final timeout.
The only thing I worry about, Mike, is when you foul, you're putting Valanciunas in an opportunity to pound the offensive board.
And there's a foul to give right there. So now they'll inbound. Less than a second went off.
And the other interesting thing is they left Herb Jones in, which I think all these decisions are hard. And you can't forget about Valanciunas for the three.
Pelicans out of timeouts. So it's not like they can get a quick two. Dort nearly knocks it. Dort with the foul on the inbound. So Ingram 8 of 9 from the line. And misses there. Now, does that change the strategy?
That's a tough decision. I would still make it.
So Najee Marshall comes in. Richardson comes in. Some of their defensive players with 10.4 remaining. OKC still has two timeouts left. Ingram gets the second one to go. Mark Daigneault will call one of those timeouts. Giddey will inbound. They still have a timeout left. Throws it inside. Shot blocked. Picked up by Dort. And a whistle and a foul. What a block on the first play. Many timeouts. Dort 77%. Hits a one there. And that makes it a three-point game. Remember, the Pelicans out of timeouts.
They must be throwing this long to bring Jackson Hayes back in.
Giddey checking with Mark Daigneault. Do we foul right away? I think he gave him the signal yes. What a game for Dort. Most points he scored all season in the biggest game of the season. And the second one is good. And that makes it a four-point game with 7 seconds remaining.
And now you just play defense.
Jones throws it. Caught by Hayes. Ingram puts up a three. Oh, it's gone. He knocks it down. Inbound to Gilgeous Alexander, and he's fouled with 2.8 remaining. Now Gilgeous Alexander knocks down the first.
And your question here is, without timeouts, do you miss? Or if you make and they throw it long again to save time, do you foul on the catch? I would foul on the catch.
And to me, I'm making the free throw.
And he does. More clutch free throws. Pelicans out of timeout. Down three. 2.8 left. Plenty of time to get a pass and a shot off. Jones looking. Finds McCollum. Oh, and he throws it away. McCollum tried to get a running start, and he throws it away. Giddey looking, throws it in, and a foul with 2.1 remaining.
Stretch. What a victory for this Thunder team.
It really is. I just love their their demeanor, like serious, professional as a young team, came in here expecting to win.
And clutch free throws again, 2.1 remaining, 5-point game. And the crowd obviously disappointed.
That will do it. This overachieving Thunder team will play another day. They'll be in Minnesota Friday night.
DeRozan out top. His performance at times has been intoxicating. Double teamed, and now 7 on the shot clock. They get it to Levine. Working against Van Vliet. Got to the rim and lays it home. He has had a huge second half. 28 in the second half and 37 overall. Van Vliet against Caruso. Siakam has the shorter Beverly on him on the outside. Good help. And Anobi, one more wide open, Trent Jr. And DeRozan comes away with the rebound.
You got to play through Zach. Zach kind of motions at DeMar. Maybe wants it on the second side. Fred VanVleet has not been able to contain Zach LaVine.
DeRozan inside, hangs and gets it.
And Mark, because they're not bringing a screener to DeMar, he's operating middle of the floor one-on-one. You like your chances.
What a comeback here. What an insurgence by the Bulls. Scotty Barnes working with it and gets fouled by Patrick Beverly, who raises his index finger, looks at Billy Donovan, says, "You need to call the timeout, coach."
Billy just puts his hands up like, "I'm not using it here." Oh, my goodness.
That's going to put Scotty Barnes at the line.
Again, another opportunity where he gets by Freddie VanVleet. Tough angle, it looks like. He makes it look easy. Now, OG Anunoby, outstanding defender. Great concentration by DeMar.
The way he hangs in the air. Hey, don't forget, coming up next, the play-in tournament presented by AT&T continues. Thunder against Pelicans. CJ McCollum, the catalyst of that attack at point guard for the Pelicans. And Brandon Ingram playing some of the best basketball of his career. That's right after this one. The winner of this game will travel to Miami and take on the Heat in a couple of days and become the number 8 seed in the aftermath. DeRozan raises up, out to Vooch. LaVine with the putback, too strong. Beverly fighting, comes away with it, but we're going to have a foul, it looks like. Boy, wonderful grit and fight by Patrick Beverly there.
After review, the defender gets his hands on the ball with Pat Bev as well. Therefore, this is a successful defensive play.
Yeah.
Because Chicago had possession of the ball when the whistle blew, they will maintain possession from the side out. Because of the successful challenge, Toronto keeps their timeout.
Okay, so it'll be Chicago basketball in the aftermath. Albeit a successful challenge, Toronto keeps its timeout while we're taking inventory. So that was the first foul in the last 2 minutes by Toronto. The Raptors have outscored. Pardon me, the Bulls have outscored the Raptors 57 to 35 in the last 9+ minutes. Caruso to trigger for the Bulls. Vucevic in the corner. They get it out quickly. LaVine working against Poeltl. Caruso on the cut. Over Barnes. Missed it, and Poeltl with the rebound. Raptors can pull to within one or tie on a three. For the tie! Barnes with the tip. Beverly with the rebound for Chicago. 1:13 to play. Barnes guarding LaVine with all of his 6'8" frame. Raptors need to stop here. LaVine, an audacious three off the mark. And VanVleet with the rebound.
Get a great shot here. You don't need the three.
That's going to be a foul against Patrick Beverly.
They've left a lot of meat on the bone, just 16 of 31. Siakam, 3 of 6. But he rattles that one in. DeMar's daughter is being very strategic about her screaming at this point.
She's timely. Check out if you're Chicago here.
Hey, she went 1 for 2 like the Raptors. Loose ball. LaVine comes out of the pack with it.
Under a minute to go. 43 seconds. 2-point ball game. Bulls with possession. LaVine crosses over on Barnes. Back out to DeRozan. Shot clock at 10. DeRozan going to work. Raises up. Fires. And he draws the foul. So DeRozan will go to the free throw line with a chance.
The crowd is reacting. Nick doesn't have his challenge, but DeMar misses the free throw. Wow.
So it's still a one-possession game. Another look here. Ananobi defending.
Wow. That's why the crowd reacted.
Three-point game. Bulls up. And Nick Nurse calls timeout. And having a very impassioned conversation. And Scotty Barnes at 28%. Here's Barnes, guarded by Vucevic. Williams has done a decent job in the second half on Siakam. Siakam on the drive, raises up, slams it home, and it's a one-point game. 19.7 to play. And some full court pressure by the Raptors. Billy Donovan wants to make sure that he can crack it.
Pressing James Williams to get him to sit down.
Caruso looking for LaVine, gets it to him. LaVine turns the corner, tripped up by Ananobi. That'll put him at the line for two, where Zach LaVine tonight is 11 of 13. Zach LaVine brought his best to the shop today. Calmly sinks the first. Patrick Williams comes in for the Bulls. Jakob Poeltl comes in for Trent Jr. Kobe White sits down for the Bulls.
Each team with one timeout. If he makes this and Toronto uses it, you get to that question about do you foul?
Yes, at a three-point advantage or not.
LaVine swishes the second. It's a three-point lead for the Bulls, and Nick Nurse burns his final timeout, and we're going to stay right here. Caruso will defend the inbound pass. They go to Siakam, guarded by Williams. Van Vliet with the screen, slips out. He threw it up.
James
There's
Williams,
a foul call.
It's going to say before, though. He's going to call
this. Say on the ground,
That's
right?
correct.
There was a lot of contact in that screening action. And the officials now are going to confer.
Oh, yeah. He's not anywhere near
no,
his motion.
No. That is on the ground.
And well before the gather, unless we're missing something. Billy Donovan
they're saying
is upset.
Three. They are. Are they changing this? Wow. So on the first gather, they're saying
okay,
that's when the foul
thing.
Occurred. Right there. Oh, wow.
Unbelievable change of events here at Scotiabank Arena. Siakam will go to the free throw line.
I feel like Billy's deciding he's going to look for some clarification to buy a little time here.
So Siakam will have a chance
wow.
to tie it here. It seemed to unfold almost in slow motion, Doris. They have struggled at the line tonight. Siakam can tie it if he makes the next two.
He's 5 of 9 from the line tonight.
Chicago with one timeout so they can advance. If he knocks these two down on the third attempt, make sure you check out.
Oh, wow. Line drive, never made it.
So now you've got to really check out, pursue the basketball. Because you know.
One possession game.
Correct.
And Chicago has to make sure they secure the defensive board here if it comes off. It does, and they do. Vucevic with the rebound, fouled by Scotty Barnes. Vucevic at the free throw line on the season, 84%. And Beverly comes in. It's a three-point Bulls lead.
Nobody gets behind you. Patrick Beverly telling DeMar DeRozan, get off the line.
It's a two-possession game. Chicago up four. And a little token pressure in the front court by Caruso. Siakam with a head of steam. Gathers it. Van Vliet fires the three. Off the mark. And this one is over. Chicago is headed to South Beach. They storm into the six and take away the win.
Was as a Bull in 2016. White to Vucevic. Ball movement here. Everybody gets a touch. DeRozan. That's a long two, and it's good. DeMar DeRozan sticks the landing, and the Bulls are up a pair.
Well, we're seeing the two veterans trading buckets and going head-to-head here in the fourth quarter. They've both been in this situation numerous times, and they're getting it done tonight.
Strauss misses a three out of bio. Can't run it down. He's been a beast on the boards. Carries that burden every night for rebounding. 15 of them tonight. Couldn't run that one down, and it'll be Chicago ball. 4:27 remaining in regulation.
And a familiar problem for the Heat, the shooting. After leading the league in three-point percentage last year, and now 27th this year, they are 2-for-13 from three in the second half.
Levine turns it over. Hero to Martin. Martin falls down, gives it right back. Levine, head up. DeRozan down in the corner. There goes Levine. He lays it. No, it's in and out. Butler with the rebound and fouled. Zach Levine here. He has averaged 24.5 a game. That's the highest among any opponent. And he calmly knocks down the first free throw. Lowry's a no-go, clearly, with the bad hammy. A bad knee, I should say. He can tie it. Butler averaged 31 in the month of April to the end of the regular season. Efficient, a playmaker, and the ultimate closer in the NBA as well. And he's taking charge now. Game's tied at 87. White, another three. And that one's good. Billy Donovan leaves Kobe White on the floor, and he responds. And the Bulls lead by three, Miami with the ball. Season is over for the loser. Winner advances. Butler had it stripped. Caruso. What a defensive play. The Bulls get the steal. They force the turnover. Chicago can add to their lead.
And they're going to go back to the same thing. Kobe White should not slip out of that screen. He should set it and make Tyler Hero defend the pick and roll.
Shot fake. White drives it. White off the glass. No. Strauss with the rebound. Missed opportunity for the Bulls. Can Miami capitalize? And Levine knocks it out of bounds from behind. 3 minutes to go. Three-point game. Heat with the ball, down three, 16 to shoot.
I'd love to see the Heat use Tyler Hero or Max Strauss as the screener for Butler and force a switch.
Hero lost Caruso. Had the invisible on him. 12 for Tyler Hero.
They're going to run the same play again. Kobe White needs to set this screen, which he does there. But he's got to get a little more separation than that.
Bulls by one. DeRozan now with 2.5 to go. The jumper, no good. Ahmad with a rebound. Bam's got 16 boards. Jimmy Butler. LaVine on him. Butler spins. Nothing there. Butler, space. He missed it. That Adebayo cannot run it down. So it remains a one-point game. The Bulls beat Spoelstra in the Heat three times this year. Twice in Miami. They swept the regular season series. Bulls down a point. Approaching the two-minute mark. DeRozan. Shot fake. Vucevic around the horn. Caruso, corner three. It's a rim, but it's Martin with a rebound. Under two we go. Miami with the lead in the ball. Into the steady hands of Butler.
I like this. Hero setting the pick.
Butler leaves it. Adebayo in traffic. No, and a foul on Vucevic. Third foul on Vucevic. Adebayo knocks down the first. 81% free throw shooter during the regular season. Bam's been a monster on the boards.
The real difference in this game right now, and what has the Heat in the lead, Brian, is the free throw line. They are plus 12 now at the free throw line. So they're shooting under 40% in the second half. And yet, and they're not making threes, they're 2 for 13 from three, but they're getting to the line.
DeRozan, that's a whistle, and I believe that's going to go on Martin.
This has been difficult.
Both coaches to another challenge. DeRozan misses a free throw. Isn't it interesting? Billy Donovan and the Bulls, their game Wednesday in Toronto defined by free throws. The misses by the Raptors, 18 for 36. They miss 18 free throws. And Chicago advanced to this game. DeRozan just misses one. Bulls are 10 of 14. DeRozan's first miss at the line. He's 8 of 9. Makes it a two-point game. And with 93 seconds left, it is Miami ball with the lead.
Who do you think the Heat will go to?
Yeah. Caruso on Butler. World-class matchup. Great defender. Great playmaker. Butler gives it up. Max Strus for three. It's good. Max gives Miami a five-point lead.
Simple, unselfish play from Jimmy Butler, drawing attention and creating the three for Max Strus.
Approaching the one-minute mark. Bulls need one badly. Oh, nifty dribbling by LaVine off the window. No! And it's cleared by Strus. Hero's the best free throw shooter. Butler is clutch at the line himself. Butler waving everybody off. Butler with Beverly on him. Now Vucevic gives it up. Strus again. And he's fouled! Max Strus is fouled on a three-pointer. Strus knocks it down. 29 now for Max Strus. Two more free throws coming.
And Max Strus, it's been a difficult year, Brian. Shot 41% from three last year, down to 35% this year. But he's come on late in the year, and now in an absolute do-or-die game, he has been outstanding.
The Chicago kid. A diehard Bulls fan growing up. Amos Alonzo Stagg High School. Then Lewis University. Then DePaul. And now he's trying to send the Bulls home. 12-1 run for the Heat. LaVine goes quick. Blocked by Adebayo. And a foul on White. Miami ball. And an 8-point lead.
on any of these benches is capable for that. To me, what sets the best players apart, what can you do to help your team win when you're not having your best night? And Bam Adebayo has done that tonight. 17 rebounds and a huge block right there.
Remember what he said in his post-game press conference after the loss Tuesday, said, I need to be involved more. Eric Spoelstra said, I agreed with him. We had a chat about it after that press conference. No problem. He's been involved tonight. What a stat line for Bam Adebayo. 17 rebounds, 8 points. Levine's three, no good. Clock ticks. Caruso fouls Butler. And now Miami poised for the put away. Miami lost the last two games. And if you're Mike Budenholzer in the Bucks, you're sitting back and just loving the play-in. Let Miami have to deal with the Atlanta Hawks losing that game. A grinder on a Friday night against the Bulls. And turn around and play 5:30 Eastern on TNT Sunday. Kobe White misses a three, and that should do it.
But Brian, I would say this going into that game. Miami has a big advantage in game one. They're in rhythm. They've been playing. The Bucks have been off a long time and set their guys at the end of the year. Those guys haven't played a game in quite a while. Look for Miami to have a great shot in game one in Milwaukee.
That's it. The Miami Heat. They will advance.
Oh, back up top, Anthony. Gary Trent Jr. for three. He's hit so many big buckets here on the bubble. And that's his first three-pointer here this afternoon. Blazers back within two.
It's about getting stops defensively because Memphis is executing and getting quality looks every time down the floor.
Ja Morant back up top. Valanciunas for three. Way short, comes all the way back to him. Morant deflected and stolen. Trent with back-to-back big plays. Nurkic. They're going to call it a side-to-side swipe. But that's also the 15th foul, so Nurkic will shoot two free throws. Overall pick in the draft after Zion Williamson. And his game is built for the NBA. And not only has he got amazing talent, but you talk to everybody with the Grizzlies, they say his basketball IQ for a 21-year-old is just off the charts.
I tell you what, as a former point guard in this league, the point guard position in this league is as good as it's ever been.
1 point game, 3.5 to play. Gary Trent Jr. assigned to try and contain Ja Morant. Brandon Clark back to Morant. Morant goes inside, reverse, he banks it home. This ties his career high in points in the most important game of his young NBA life. McCollum for three. CJ McCollum from downtown. And the game is tied.
Of your Memphis, you knew that they was going to make big shots. Continue to execute.
Morant inside. Bank shot won't go. He thought he was fouled as Carmelo Anthony gets the rebound.
And this time Dylan Brooks is on CJ McCollum, so they try to set a screen and get him off of him.
McCollum kicks it out. Anthony for three. Rebound. Nurkic banks it home and a foul. And Portland has regained the lead. Nurkic, who looks exhausted now with 20 points and 20 rebounds.
But how about the shot by CJ? Gets him ISO'd on Ja Morant, little shoulder. Gets him on his heels and then step back, knocks down the jump shot. And how about this big guy, Nurkic? He's been outstanding all game long. The offensive rebound and the three-point play.
Well, they did it the first time they played in the bubble. Portland was down 9 with 5 to go. They've been down as many as 8 here in the fourth quarter. Now lead by 3. Good ball denied from McCollum. Brooks gets it back, splits the defense, goes inside. Nurkic tips it back out, saved by Allen. Morant floats it up. Rebound Nurkic. Knocked out of bounds off of his leg, and it's Memphis ball. I believe Portland had gained possession, so the shot clock should reset to 24, and it does.
But go back to the Brooklyn game with Portland. How many times did the Brooklyn Nets get offensive rebounds? The last line of your defense is securing the basketball.
Brooks Valanciunas inadvertently took a shot in the face and throws it away. Allen dives, comes up with the ball, a scramble. Clark throws it up. Valanciunas lays it in. A broken play leads to 2 points.
What a game, Mike.
Under two to play. Blazers now clinging to a one-point lead. McCollum, a three-pointer. Bang! C.J. McCollum from downtown.
We talked about it, this, how special Damian Lillard was, but he has a sidekick that can take over games also in C.J. McCollum.
Ja Morant had it deflected and turns it over.
And now what they're doing is making Ja Morant defend C.J. McCollum. Yeah, you're special on the offensive end, but we're going at you defensively.
McCollum, 12 of his 27 here in the fourth quarter. Drives, pulls up, puts it in. C.J. McCollum, clutch here in the fourth quarter, and Portland has a six-point lead. 60 points combined, 31 for Lillard, 29 for McCollum. Valanciunas back to Morant, gets inside, reverse, bank shot is good. Morant the magnificent. A four-point game, a career high for Ja Morant.
And bring in Grayson Allen, so it takes Ja Morant and puts him on Gary Trent. Now you have a matchup you can live with defensively, but they're forcing him to switch in this action here.
McCollum gets away, fakes, fires three-pointer. Grayson Allen tracks it down. And here comes Ja Morant. Still four-point game, under a minute to play. Morant, the hesitation. Shot blocked by Trent. And it's still Memphis ball with 15 to shoot. Grizzlies still have a timeout left.
Good job by Gary Trent Jr. getting back into the pitcher, blocking the shot attempt. You have to be committed to making Ja Morant take anything away from the rim, and you live with the results.
Good ball denial. Allen was almost out of bounds. Now drives. Shot is up. Rolls off the rim. And a foul. And Grayson Allen will shoot free throws with 42.8 remaining. Nurkic with his fifth foul. This is the first free throw attempt of the fourth quarter for the Grizzlies. Allen here in the bubble is now 10 of 11 from the free throw line. Regular season 87%, a great free throw shooter. Misses the second. And Valanciunas caused it to go out of bounds, so it's still a three-point game. They can look at it.
Look to get a stop.
Both teams are in the penalty. Blazers have four fouls, so the next one will put them in the penalty as well. Grayson Allen is guarding Lillard.
And that's a better matchup than Dillon Brooks defending C.J. McCollum. So they're going to clear it out and let him play.
Lillard one-on-one with Allen. Drives. Kicks it out, Anthony. Anthony for three. Bang! Carmelo Anthony makes it a six-point game. Perhaps in the season of the Grizzlies, they're down six. Valanciunas, Brooks. Brooks fires a three. Got it! Dillon Brooks from downtown, and it's back to three. 15.4 remaining. It only took less than 5 seconds. McCollum in the backcourt. Throws it ahead to Gary Trent. And Trent is fouled with 9.1 remaining. 2% free throw shooter. Yeah, that's huge, making it a four-point game. Portland trailed by eight with about 2.5 gone by here in the fourth quarter. And then C.J. McCollum and the Blazers making clutch play after clutch play.
And Memphis with no timeouts must push the basketball.
Trent on a big statistical game, but he made some big defensive plays. Ball deflected. Anthony has it. And Anthony fouled by Tolliver. A huge offensive rebound that pretty much seals this with 6.2 remaining. Carmelo Anthony did not shoot the ball well. It was 1 of 6 from three, but that one three-pointer that he nailed was such a clutch shot. Now 9 of 9 from the free throw line, so he's got 20 points. Four Blazers with 20 or more. And Carmelo Anthony putting on some finishing touches. Back to 6. Ja Morant stops, fires, and hits the three-pointer. And that makes it 3 again. They're going to review to whether or not his foot was inside. One timeout left in case it gets close to that. They throw it in, and Nurkic is immediately fouled. The clock now says 9/10 of a second remaining. This game is not considered a regular season game. It's not considered a playoff game. It's kind of statistical limbo in terms of where the numbers go. But it has been, despite a strange scenario with a play-in game, what a wonderful game. As Nurkic hits the free throw for the fan. Certainly heartbreaking for the Grizzlies and their fans. But for the NBA fan, watch these two teams go at it for the right to make the NBA playoffs. It has been a special afternoon. And that'll do it. The Portland Trail Blazers are in the 2020 postseason. They'll face the Lakers on Tuesday night as they overcome a young and gritty Memphis Grizzlies team here this afternoon.